To me, there's a difference between being a dad and being a father. To me, a dad gives DNA and a last name, but a father gives instructions, identity, and guidance. Hi, my name is Ronnie Roque, with Who Me Be a Leader, and today I want to talk to you in the wake of Father's Day. I want to talk to you a little bit about growing up without a father, because I had some comments on the blog, and it says that I look like I'm an involved father, and I am. And it's only because I was driven as a man to be the best father that I can be since I knew what it was like to grow up without a father. Growing up without a father really leaves you vulnerable. And in that vulnerability, as a young man, I was molested. Now, I don't know what all that entailed at the time when it happened, but I know what it did to me in the aftermath of it. And what it done is it made me angry against men. And because of that, it made me distance with men, and it made me not trust men. And so when I look at that, and God had to really work with me on that, and today I still have issues with men and being friends with men. Now, but the thing about it is in my heart, I lack that fathering. And even today, you lack that personal touch as a father. Now, what is a father supposed to do? He's supposed to protect and provide for his children. And the fact is because I didn't have a father around, and God gave that practical role to a father. He gave the tender and nurturing role to a mother. And being without a father left me vulnerable to this world. I didn't have any morals or knew what the standards were, for the simple reason because I was moving according to what I knew. And you know the Bible say that, hey, there's a way that seemed right unto a man, but the end there is death. And so the thing about it is I was moving according to what I knew. And the only thing I knew was what I seen, what I heard, or what I was around. So when you're without a father, you're vulnerable to this world. And so when I think about it, the first time that I encountered my father after my mom and dad split when I was 3, and I was the youngest of 4 boys. And so after they split, I didn't see my father again until I was 17 years old. And at that time, I really didn't know what to expect. I really didn't know how to think about him, because I've heard some stories, you know, as a young man, you hear stories and it builds up in you. And so the next time I encountered my father, what happened is he displayed just the stories that I had heard. He was an angry man, and I don't know from which that came from, because he could have had a father that was absentee. But what I want to say to you is this. I want to say growing up without a father really leaves you empty, because God has structured the home right. He said there is Christ before men ahead of woman, and God ahead of all. And so a father plays a vital role when it comes down to being involved in the family. And so I want to say to you is that when you're not around your kids, you leave them vulnerable to the world. Also, the other thing, the time that at the age of 32, I remember being around men that had fathers, and they was involved with their fathers. They did activities with them, and their fathers showed them things. And I can remember that emptiness coming up in me, because hearing them talk about that, I was missing that. And I know I had never encountered that, never experienced that. And I think that's what has made my source today, as far as dealing with men, being even more a driving force, for the simple reason because I wanted them to know just how important their role is to a family. Because one of the things that I realize about men is this: because we're not in a place, sometimes we forget about that place, and we have to be reminded of that place. And sometimes when men walk away from their family, they try to forget about that for whatever reason. I don't know the reason, but I just know for me, and growing up without a father, I didn't have that instruction. I didn't have that guidance. I didn't have somebody that can cover me and show me right from wrong. And I had to learn that stuff on my own. And I paid a heavy price for it. And so I thank God for his grace and his mercy. And that being without a father is what drove me when I had my own kids to be involved with my kids, no matter what that entailed, that I was going to be involved with my kids. And men, sometimes when they have issues with the mother, then they have issues with the kid. And I want to say to you men is that don't make your kid pay for something that they didn't do. Because remember, it took two in order for that kid to get here. So if the split come, remember, be responsible, because I think that's what makes a man is when he's responsible for his kids, no matter what that take, because God is gonna hold you accountable for it, so you might as well be responsible for it. So if I can think of one thing that really, really hurt me when it come down to not having a father, which is this. Is being without a father left an emptiness in me that nobody have ever been able to fill. And not only that, the good thing about it is that it drove me to stick close to my kids, because what I'm supposed to do is instruct my kids to be a spiritual human being and to be what God wants them to be. Because as God instruct me, then I should instruct my kids. So I want to thank you for your comments. I want to thank you for your encouragement on this blog. And remember, men, Father's Day is not just one day, it's all year round. And so I want to keep you in mind. And then I want to challenge you to really give your kids a chance. And how do you give your kids a chance? That you do in accordance to what God has called, that you leave a legacy. Remember, the scripture said a good man leaves an inheritance while he's alive, meaning that, hey, he can instruct, he can protect, he can provide while he's alive, because when it's all said and done, we can't go back and redo anything. We can only move forward in what God has in our lives. So I want to challenge you, men, to be the man that God has called you to be, that you may leave an inheritance, a legacy. And you have to ask yourself the question, what do I want my kids to best remember when it's all said and done and I'm gone? What do I want my kids to think about when they've grown up and have their own kids? Are they going to be talking about how dad instructed them? Are they going to be talking about how dad was there for them? Are they going to be talking about the absentee of you not being there? And don't be one of those type of dads. So until I see you next time, may God bless you and keep you as our prayer. And remember, an unexamined life is an unbalanced life. God bless you and happy Father's Day to all you fathers out there. And be the father that God has called you to be. God bless you.